Good morning, student. I'm Rose. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is Standard 7, History, Chapter 9, Developments of Regional Culture. The topic is the developments of regional culture. So, as we know, in the last chapters, we have learned about the different political life we learned about. Then you have some of the important chapters we have learned about the what we call architectures of architecture in medieval period, what are the development happened in architecture. Then we learn about the how the different peoples or the tribes people started to settle down, or what are the changes happen in the different mobiles and tribes people. Yes or no? Then you have after that you learn about what are the religions or what are the changes happen in religion. Yes or no? So today in this chapter we are going to learn about different languages or different dialects which developed in different regions of India, and how these cultures and languages make difference in the medieval period. Okay, so actually we know the topic is development of regional cultures. So here the meaning that regional means different regions or different parts of India, and the cultures means that means the way of life of different regions. Okay, so culture refers to both the customs and beliefs, art, way of life, and the social organization in particular areas or particular regions of the country. Okay, so then during the medieval period, that means during the medieval period, so many changes happened, so many regional languages originated, so many different languages originated in different parts of India. Okay, so we can say that it brought a distinctive, we can say particular languages in distinctive or significant changes among the social, or we can say among the people of different regions of India. Okay, so let us see what are the languages, what are the literature, what are the cultures, what are the beliefs which changes during the medieval period. Okay, so today in this we will focus on the languages and literature which developed during the medieval period. Okay, so here some of the notes I have written. Okay, so the regions and regional. Okay, so we can say the languages as an identification of area. That means the languages which is being spoken in different parts of India or different parts of the country refers an important identification, and this mainly refers to the refers the which way of life, what are the way, what are the cultures that can be or are being followed in different regions of the country. Okay, so this we can say languages we can take as an identification of the different regions of India. Okay, and including that you can say it create or it includes both languages and literature, even the clothes, food, poetry, dance, paintings. All these shows the cultures of different regions. All these shows the cultures of different regions. So let us see what are the languages, what are the literature, or what are the developments happen in the medieval period. Let us see first of all the languages and literatures of changes or the development happen in the medieval period. Okay, so there were the many significant developments of regional languages and literature happen in the medieval period, and not only in the regional languages but also the religious literature and also the secular literature. Also the secular literature, religious literature we can say like it's a Ramayana, then you have the Gita. Okay, these kind of books are called as the religious literature, and secular literature means we can say like we can say stories of different kings and things like as a travelers, right, or biographies of different kings and different part of regions of India. Okay, so that are called the secular literature. Okay, so we can say there was various languages or religious literature, religious secular literature, or the regional languages which developed during the medieval period. Okay, so first of all let us see the languages. Let us see about the languages. Okay, the number of languages such as Gujarati, Marathi, Rajasthani, Bengali, different regions or different parts of India. For example, let us see Gujarati. For example, Gujarati is a language of Gujarat, that we know. Then we have the Marathi. Marathi is a language of Maharashtra. Yes. Then we have the Rajasthan. Rajasthani. Rajasthani is a language of Rajasthan. Then we have Bengali. Bengali is a language of West Bengal and Bangladesh. Yes. Then you have Assamese. Assamese is a language of Assam. Then Oriya. Oriya is a language of Orissa. Okay. So these are the different regional or different regional languages which developed during the medieval period. Okay. So there are the religious teachers and these all languages or we can say religious teachers often used to press the regional. Regional language, that means different region. For example, Oriya, or we can say Orissa. Okay, so the people of the teachers are the teacher or the religious teachers, like we used to teach the students of different students of different region. So these teachers, what they used to do, they used to preach the word, they used to preach the regional language as Oriya and Orissa. Okay, so this kind of changes, this kind of development happen in different regions. For example, let us see some of the examples how the different languages are developed in different regions. Let us see the Chola region in South India. Okay, that you know, you have learned about the Chola region in standard 6. Yes, so Chola region is present in some part of near the deltas of Kaveri River. Okay, which is now in Tamil Nadu. Okay, in this region, main important languages which prospered or which came into existence was the Tamil, Telugu and the Kannada. Okay, so these are the important three languages which become so much famous, and these all languages are being related to the these all languages came from the Sanskrit language, or because they are all used for the administrative works after that. Okay, so this language was the languages this Telugu, Tamil and Kannada were the main regional languages which was used in the Chola region. Okay, next is the Cheras region, which is now in Kerala. Cheras, we can say these are some part of Kerala. Okay, so again, this Cheras region, the people of Cheras region mainly patronize the Malayalam language. They patronize mainly the Malayalam language. Okay, and we can say this in Mahodiyapuram, that means Mahodiyapuram is a name of a region, we can say place of Chera kingdom, which comes under the Chera culture, now in some part of the Kerala. Okay, and they use Mahodiyapuram in this region, mainly. Firstly, this Mahodiyapuram used the Malayalam language in that kingdom. Okay, then you have this language, this Malayalam language is influenced by the Tamil languages. It is being influenced by the Tamil languages, and this Malayalam language is well kept, we can say the records or the chronicles which was being written by the kings. They used to write this this in the Malayalam languages, in a Malayalam language. That means we can say it this they use one of the important official language in the Cheras region or the Cheras kingdom. Okay, and this language has some of the Sanskritic dialect. Sanskritic dialect means something which is related to this language. Okay, so this Malayalam is being both came from the Tamil language, and also it sees or it is being connected with the Sanskritic culture. Sanskritic culture means in a Sanskrit way how they used to speak, and it is related to that. Okay, so this is how the Malayalam languages was being we can say came into new languages which came into the Cheras region or the Cheras kingdom. Okay, next, the new languages which after the reign of that means before the Delhi Sultan and the Mughals. Okay, so these Cheras, Cholas regions were the more important in South India. Yes, no? So they were ruling before them also. Okay, but so when this when the Arabic, or we can say when the Delhi Sultanate came to existence, and the Mughals who came to India, they brought the two languages that they brought in India, that was the Arabic and Persian. That was the Arabic and Persian. Okay, and languages, Persian became a very important and very significant language of the reign of these two reigns. Okay, that is of this Delhi Sultan and the Mughals, Mughal period. Okay, and it was used as the administrative language. This Persian was used as the administrative language or the court language. Court languages means because the official languages which is used, which was used during the king's court. Okay. Out of this, what happened? The Persian and the with the Hindi languages, what happened? Persian languages work for, or we can say, remain for hundreds of years. So what happens? Out of this Persian and the Hindi languages, the new language came into existence. That was the Urdu.
Many Pravala, and
corals, diamonds and corals. Okay, so this Manipuram is a languages, okay, which means we can say diamonds and corals, and this both refers to these diamonds and corals refers to two important languages, that is the two languages Sanskrit and the regional languages of Kerala, that is the Malayalam. Okay, so this Manipuram means this language, this Manipuram refers to both languages Sanskrit and the Malayalam languages. Okay, which means Sanskrit refers to diamonds and the Malayalam refers to corals, which means that. Okay, so this is how these different part of India or different regions of India took the dialects of Sanskrit literature to immerse the new languages in different regions of India. Okay, so this shows how the different languages saw their cultures and traditions, belief in different parts of India. Yes or no? According to that, so these languages become a important identification of different parts of India or different regions of India. So in this topic, we'll here we will study. In the next topic, we will learn about some word about what through the languages, what are the different belief or the art came into flourish during the early medieval period, and the medieval period like paintings, dances, then you have the music, religious beliefs, then you have the what are the different region heroes and heroism or different different regions of India. Okay, thank you for now.